You guys put, as a Big Ten conference, you guys put these coaches in place to lead these kids. These kids respect the Big Ten, the schools that they play for, and they listen to the coaches. I think they need to trust the coaches. They really need to trust in what they're doing and how they're proceeding and anything they're doing with these kids. I mean, we need a fall season. I have a lot of kids that are seniors, that are juniors, that are sophomores that want to play, including mine. They work hard for this. They work entirely hard. They're very responsible through the whole COVID situation when we didn't even know it was a COVID. They have been responsible. They've set 20% capacity in the stadium, we've accepted it. They've lessened our tickets, we've accepted it. They said we may not be able to meet with our kids after the game, we've accepted it. We need answers. Right. Give us options. Let these kids decide. Even if you said no fans can be in the stadium, let them play. Let them play. Trust the coaches. What else do you want? It's no way you can't tell us that the Big Ten can't get it together, that the ACC can get it together, that the SEC can get it together. The Big Ten can do the same. And we can do it like clockwork. We can do it we can do it immediately. We have it to do. We are the Big Ten. As we stand and fight, we need the Big Ten Conference to stand and fight at any given time.
Sorry.
Andrea Tate. A-N-D-R-E-A. Last name is T-A-T-E.
And your sign?
Seven Banks. Cornerback, Ohio State. Let's go. Let's play.
If you can rip a fall, you can rip a spring. If you can take fall with the blink of an eye within 72 hours, you can take spring.
Yeah.
That's sitting out, what is that, a year and a half is what we're talking about, sitting out a season? So I'm not just fighting for my son. There are players that this year is critical for them, including my son. Maybe including his son. I don't care whose son it is. We'll play whoever's son want to play. Just let us play.
Are there any parents or players, young men, talking about transferring to schools and the conferences they're planning to play?
I haven't heard any. Okay. I haven't heard of any. I think that we're still praying to see if things can be overturned. I mean, like they say, they sent out that last letter and it still wasn't enough. It still wasn't enough. So, you know, they can overturn it 2 days before the season started. I'm pretty sure Coach Dave will load up, you know. At this point, we're just going to continue to fight until we can, until it's just the last end. So I definitely think that a season needs to happen. And like I say, you know, you have no matter who's getting paid, who's not getting paid, I've heard it all. NFL players and NBA, they're playing because they're getting paid. Paid amateur, all that. I think that's just another reason trying to give an answer. If high school is playing, if Pop Warner is playing, if NFL is playing, college needs to play. I'm speaking for all conferences. Whoever do not want to play, we can put together a schedule that doesn't include them. Any players that do not want to play, there's always an option. Do not give us an option. And do the players get their year back? That's another question. Do they lose it? Or do they get it back? Then is there a scholarship issue with recruits and the ones who you're giving scholarships to? The most certainty for me is to have a fall season.
You talked about trusting the coaches. What made you so confident in Coach Day that he was doing everything he needed to do to keep your son safe?
I'm very confident in coach. I'm confident in every coach on that staff. Because of how I see the kids, how they respect the coaches, not just their position coaches. Remember, we're also a recruit of Urban Meyer. So I still have a lot of respect for him as well, including the president that's not there. I haven't met President Johnson. I mean, I don't know much about her. But to have the, when I say to that they need to trust these coaches, this Penn State, Iowa, Wisconsin, these coaches are going hard for these kids. They're with these kids day in and day out. If any one of these kids get in trouble, the coaches have a protocol and a process that they have to go through to make sure they did the right thing or they get scrutinized. So why now not take what they feel about if they can make it happen or not? This is what I'm saying. You can't trust them sometimes and then not trust them now. Trust them every time.
She's gonna fight your fingers.
How do you feel about the prospect of a spring season? Would you be concerned about your son playing two seasons in 1 year?
I'm not concerned about my son because, you know, you got to know your son. I know my son can do it. But the problem is I'm concerned of, will there be one? You can tell us whatever it is. If you can pull a fall season, what makes spring so much safer? What makes spring? I don't care anything about a vaccine. Who's lining up to go take a vaccine? When, how long does it take a vaccine to be tested before it's actually placed on the market? So come, let's just, we just, this is what, just like the Iowa parent said, listen, we have to live with COVID. It's going to be here now. It's going to be here in January. We have to learn to live with it. We got to learn to play with it. And for everybody on that, on the team that they're playing against and with, we know that they've been tested. Right now, they're still being tested and there's no season. So let them play.